We want to find a plane that contains the points 3, 2, 1, 4, 5, 6, and 7, 8, 9. Now, we know how to find a plane if we know a normal vector and a point. But if we only know 3 points on the plane, how do we find the normal vector? Well, let's start by drawing these points. So say these are our 3 points. So this is 3, 2, 1, and this is 4, 5, 6, and this one is 7, 8, 9. Then we can find 2 vectors in our plane by subtracting our points. So these 2 vectors, let's call them u and v, we can find by subtracting the head from the tail. So v is going to equal 7, 8, 9 minus 3, 2, 1, which would be 4, 6, 8. And u is going to equal 4, 5, 6 minus 3, 2, 1, which is 1, 3, 5. So now we have 2 vectors that lie in our plane. If we want to get a vector perpendicular to those 2 vectors, we need to find to cross them. So if we do 4, 6, 8 crossed with 1, 3, 5, then we're looking at I, J, K, 4, 6, 8, 1, 3, 5, which is I times six, eight, three, five, minus J times 4, 8, 1, 5, plus K times 4, 6, 1, 3, which gives us I times, remember you did cross these, so 6 times 5 is 30, minus 8 times 3 is 24, minus J times 4 times 5 is 20, minus 8, plus K, 4 times 3 is 12, minus 6 times 1 is 6. So simplifying, this is 6i minus 12j plus 6k, which is the vector 6 minus 12, 6. So now we can find an equation for our plane. 6x minus 3 minus 12y minus 2 plus 6 z minus 1 equals 0. All right, now we want to determine if the following planes intersect, and if they intersect, determine the line of intersection. So the first thing we can do is look at the normal vectors for these planes. So the normal vector for the first plane is 3, 2, negative 5. And the normal vector for the second plane is 2, negative 3, 1. And notice that these normal vectors are not multiples of each other, so they don't lie on the same line. So they're not parallel. Therefore, the planes are going to intersect. So now what do? Well, we want to start with a point that we know is on that intersection. So let's assume that the line of intersection intersects the plane z equals 0. So if z equals 0, then the first plane is, we're looking at the line 3x plus 2y equals 9. And the second plane, we're looking at the line 2x minus 3y equals 2. Now he has a system of 2 equations and 2 unknowns. So we can solve. Let's multiply the first line through by 2 and the second line through by 3. So that would give us 6x plus 6y plus 4y equals 18. And 6x minus 9y equals 6, and now we can subtract these. So 6x minus 6x goes away. 4 minus a negative 9 is 13y, and 18 minus a negative, or minus 6 is 12. So y is 12 thirteenths. And then we can find x. We can plug back in, or we could take our original equation and multiply the top one by 3 and the bottom one by 2. If we did that, we would be looking at 6x plus 6y equals 27. Not 6x, 9x. And 4x minus 6y equals 4. And now we add these two lines, we get 13x equals 31. So x equals 31 thirteenths. And that gives us a point that's on our line of intersection. And that point is going to be x is 31 thirteenths, y is 12 thirteenths, and z is 0. So to find an equation of a line, we need a point, and we need a vector in that direction. So to find a vector in that direction, we want something that's perpendicular to both of our normal vectors. So to find that, we're going to cross our two normal vectors. So let's go over here, and we're going to look at 3, 2, negative 5, crossed with 2, negative 3, 1, which is IJK, 2, oops, 3, 2, negative 5, 2, negative 3, 1, which gives you I times 2 times 1 minus negative 5 times negative 3, so 15, minus J times 3 times 1 minus negative 5 times 2, so plus 10, plus K times 3 times negative 3, so negative 9, minus 2 times 2, so minus 4. Alright, so we're looking at the vector negative 13i minus 13j minus 13k. Alright, so here's a vector in our direction, and we can make this simpler if we want to by just saying that a vector in the same direction as this one is 1, 1, 1, since those are all 13s. Now we have a point, and we have a normal vector, so we can find the equation of the line. So we just take our point, so we say x, y, z is equal to our point, 31 thirteenths, 12 thirteenths, 0, plus t times our vector, which is 1, 1, 1. And that's the equation of our line. Alright, now we have another problem to determine if the following planes intersect, and if they intersect, draw the line of intersection. So again, let's look at the normal vectors. So the first one is 3, 2, negative 5. The second one is 6, 4, negative 10. Now notice that these are multiples of each other. If you take the first one, you multiply by 2, you're going to get the second one. Therefore, the planes are parallel. Now I do need to check that they're not actually the same plane. So we can do that by just multiplying this whole expression by 2. So we would get 6x plus 4y minus 10z equals 18. And now we can see that's not the same as 6x plus 4y minus 10z equals 2. So they're parallel, but they're not the same. Okay. Now here we want to sketch the surface z equals y squared. So in both of these examples, they're easier to draw because they don't depend on all three variables. So here when we're looking at z equals y squared, we need just z and y. We can ignore the x. So first let's just draw it as if it was in 2D. You see this teal Cartesian plane? That's the one we're going to draw in. So z equals y squared goes through 0, 0, goes through 1, 1, goes through 2, 4, negative 1, 1, negative 2, 4, so there's a parabola. in the YZ plane. But it's going to be the same parabola if we shift it, you know, any along the x-axis. So let's go a couple spots forward along the x-axis, and let's draw the same parabola. And let's go a couple spots back and draw the same parabola again. And now all of these are on our surface, and we can kind of make it look like a surface by just kind of connecting the edges here. And of course it keeps coming out in both directions. I know it's hard to, it's really, really hard to draw these things by hand. But that should give you an idea of what it looks like. It kind of looks like a bent sheet of paper. We call anything that is just like one shape but stretched out a cylinder. All right, so now we want to use our knowledge of traces to sketch y equals z squared over 4 plus x squared over 4. And we've determined that when x equals 0, this looks like a parabola. It's a little bit fat. It goes through 2, 1 and negative 2, 1. So this is in the yz plane. So let's go over here in the yz plane. So here's yz. If y was up on top, it's opening towards y. It has points at 0 and 2s, and looks like this. And then we've also determined that when y equals 4, it looks like a circle, radius 4. So y equals 4, go out 1, 2, 3, 4. Here's y equals 4. So imagine a plane parallel to the xz plane at y equals 4. So what's going on at y equals 4? 1, 2, 3, 4. Well, I think we didn't draw our parabola quite right, because it should be going through the points, these points right here. So let's work on that a little bit. So here's our parabola. And then now here we have a circle of radius 4. And you can start to see what this surface is going to look like. It's some kind of sideways paraboloid, which if you check in your book at the chart, matches with what it says there. Now we want to draw level curves for the function f of xy equals y minus x squared minus 1 when f of xy is equal to negative 2, 0, and 2. So this is to give us an idea of what this curve would look like in 3D. So when this is essentially, this should be x. So z is essentially our height, right? But we're assuming this is a function, which is why we call it f of xy. So when f of xy, or z, is equal to negative 2, we're looking at negative 2 equals y minus x squared minus 1. So we bring the negative 1 and the x squared to the other side. We have y equals x squared minus 1. And so now you have a parabola there. And this is the, let's label it in another color. This is the z equals negative 2 parabola. Alright, let's do the next one in another color. We'll kind of keep track that way. So when f of xy is equal to 0, then we have 0 equals y minus x squared minus 1. So y is equal to x squared plus 1. So now we're shifting up a little bit, but otherwise the graph looks the same. And so this is our graph when z equals 0. And then we can do it again for when our function height is 2. So 2 equals y minus x squared minus 1. So y is equal to x squared plus 3. And so again, we can draw that one. It just shifts it up again. So what's going on here in our surface is you need to imagine that the blue line is higher than the black line and the green line is higher than the blue line. And so it's kind of like that same folded piece of paper we had before, only kind of at a diagonal now, where each parabola is getting up higher than the one before. And you can see a picture of the actual surface if you click on the written solution tab. All right, now we want to draw the level curves for f of x, y equals e to the negative x squared, negative y squared. For f of x equals 0.1, 0.3, and 0.7. So we can get an idea of what this surface looks like. So let's do the same kind of technique as before. So when f of x, y is equal to 0.1, then we have 0.1 equals e to the negative x squared minus y squared. So we take log of both sides, so natural log of 0.1 is equal to negative x squared minus y squared. Notice that natural log of 0.1 is going to be a negative number. So if we multiply everything through by negative 1, we'll get positive numbers. So we get x squared plus y squared equals negative natural log of 0.1. So this is a circle with radius the square root of negative natural log of 0.1, and I have no idea what that is, so we'll check a calculator real quick. That is approximately 1.517. So it's a circle of approximately radius 1.5. Okay, so let's try it again. When f of xy is equal to 0.3. So we have 0.3 equals e to the negative x squared minus y squared. The algebra is going to be the same. We take the natural log of both sides, take the negative of both sides, and now we have a circle of radius square root of negative natural log of 0.3. So that is equal to approximately 1.01, and I guess this shouldn't be surprising because closer you get to natural log of 0, the bigger the value would get. So closer we get to natural log of 1 from below, it's going to get closer to 1. Or it's going to get closer and closer to 0. Natural log of 1 is 0. Okay, so we want a circle of radius about 1. And then for 0.07, you can, I'm going to guess that the algebra is exactly the same. So I'll let you do that algebra. And you're going to end up with a circle of radius square root of negative natural log of 0.7, which is approximately 0.597. So a little bit bigger than a half. And so now when we look at these level curves, what we can see is that as this function gets bigger, but not too big. I'm not sure what would happen if we tried to put, if we tried to put in a number bigger than 1, we would have weird things going on. We'd have square roots of negative 7. As it gets closer and closer to 1, it seems to be making a bump here. Maybe at a height of 1 over the 0.00. And if you look on the written solutions, it will actually show you a final surface for this as well.